हेलो गाइस, टुडे विल सी प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स। इन दैट फर्स्ट इज बाय ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ प्राइमरी अल्कोहल। सो प्राइमरी अल्कोहल इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ पोटेशियम डाइक्रोमेट दैट इज K2Cr2O7 इन सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड सॉल्यूशन H2SO4, और वी कैन टेक पोटेशियम पर मैग्नेट इंस्टेड ऑफ पोटेशियम डाइक्रोमेट। पोटेशियम पर मैग्नेट इज KMnO4। So primary alcohol is oxidized into aldehyde. So similar reactions are given here. Here instead of potassium dichromate or potassium permanganate, PCC is used, that is pyridinium chlorochromate. Methylene chloride is solvent here. So again primary alcohol gets converted into aldehyde by using PCC in methylene chloride. Same reaction with different compound. This OH converts into the CH2OH gets converted into CHO. Other thing remains same. So pyridinium chlorochromate as well as potassium dichromate and potassium permanganate, these all are oxidizing agents. So they oxidize primary alcohol into aldehyde. CH2OH is converted into CHO in all those reactions. Next is by dehydrogenation of primary alcohols. So copper metal is used for dehydrogenation. It will remove hydrogen from primary alcohol. So 2H are removed, hydrogen gas is evolved, and what remains is aldehyde. So this is second method for preparation of aldehyde. Third is by hydrocarbons. There are two. This method, hydrocarbons means they contain carbon and hydrogen, like alkenes, alkanes, alkynes. So hydrocarbons are alkene, alkene, alkynes, which contains only carbon and hydrogen. Here we'll see alkenes and alkynes. So first is by ozonolysis of alkenes. So ozone is added to an alkene and we'll get this structure. Okay, this is a structure like a house, and when it is treated with water, zinc, it gets broken down in this fashion. So this RCHO will be one product. Next is R-CHO, and this oxygen goes with zinc to give zinc oxide. So that happens in ozonolysis reaction. Just write down this as it is, and these three oxygens, one above and two below, and then cut them like this, and we are getting two aldehydes. They can be same, can be different depending upon these R groups. Next type of hydrocarbon reaction is by hydration of alkynes. So alkynes are hydrated with water. So in this acetylene, we know that in double and triple bond, in double bond there is one sigma bond and second bond is pi bond. Pi bond is always weaker than sigma bond. Like that in acetylene there is one sigma bond and two pi bonds. So those pi bonds are easy to break. So addition reaction happens here in hydration of alkynes. So one of the hydrogen gets added to one carbon and remaining OH gets added to other carbon. And after that we'll get this unstable intermediate. For this reaction H2SO4 and HgSO4 or HgSO4 are used at 333 Kelvin, and rearrangement of this converts into acetaldehyde. So we can convert acetylene into acetaldehyde by treatment of acetylene with water in the presence of H2SO4, HgSO4, 333 Kelvin. First we'll get unstable intermediate that will directly get converted into acetaldehyde. So that was the third type from hydrocarbons. In that we saw two: by ozonolysis of alkenes and by hydration of alkynes. Now next is from acyl chloride. So this reaction is known as Rosenmund reduction reaction. In this acyl chloride treated with hydrogen gas in the presence of palladium barium sulfate catalyst. So palladium metal is used for this reaction, and it is पैलेडियम मेटल सपोर्ट इज ऑन बेरियम सल्फेट. सल्फर इज यूज फॉर सम व्हाट पॉइजनिंग द रिएक्शन टू स्लो द रिएक्शन. सल्फर इज यूज. सो आर सी ओ सी एल एच टू. वॉट इज डन हियर, दिस सी एल गेट रिप्लेस्ड बाय हाइड्रोजन. ओनली यू हैव टू डू दैट, रिप्लेस दिस क्लोरिन विद हाइड्रोजन. From where this hydrogen come? From this H2. Okay, and this Cl and other hydrogen will give HCl. So that reaction is known as Rosenmund reduction reaction. So one example is there, acetyl chloride, CH3COCl, derivative of carboxylic acid. With hydrogen under presence of palladium, barium, sulfate, sulfur, it will give acetaldehyde plus HCl. Then next is from nitriles and esters. So tin chloride with HCl gives SnCl4, and hydrogen gas is generated. Two hydrogens are generated in this reaction. So they react with cyanide, that is CN, and they will form this intermediate, and ultimately that converts into aldehyde. So in short, cyanide gets converted into aldehyde by using this reagent SnCl2 plus HCl. Okay, it will give two hydrogens to them, and because of that cyanide gets converted into aldehyde. So this reaction is called Stefan reaction, when cyanide gets converted into aldehyde in the presence of tin chloride and HCl. The reaction is known as Stefan reaction. Some examples are given of this. So cyanide gets converted into CHO in the presence of diol H and water. Again, for this CN gets converted into CHO, diol H water. And here there is ester group. So this part OCH2CH3 gets converted into H by diol H. Okay, other product will be alcohol, but we have to write the main product here. That is aldehyde. So ester can be converted into aldehyde by using this reaction. Just replace OCH2CH3 by H. So this is the reaction. And now let's see preparation of benzaldehyde, that is aromatic aldehyde. So first is by oxidation of toluene. Toluene is the one which is having CH3 on benzene ring. So by oxidizing toluene in presence of CrO2Cl2 and carbon disulfide, we'll get a chromium complex which is OCrOHCl2, and after treating that with hydronium ion, we'll get benzaldehyde. In short, CH3 gets converted into CHO by oxidation of toluene, and the reagent used is CrO2Cl2. So this reaction is known as Itard reaction for preparation of benzaldehyde. Another such reaction, toluene plus CrO3, acetic anhydride is taken as a solvent. We'll get a complex benzylidine diacetate. CH is attached to OCOCH3 two times, and again that is treated with hydronium ion, will get benzaldehyde. So again CH3 converted into CHO, and acetic acid are the byproduct for this reaction. So this was the first preparation of benzaldehyde by oxidation of toluene. Next preparation is by side chain chlorination followed by hydrolysis. So in the presence of HMU, that is light, one of the hydrogen gets replaced by chlorine. So mechanism is a free radical reaction, initiation, propagation, termination. So like that the hydrogen is removed and chlorine gets attached, and when it is treated with hydronium ion, it gets converted into benzaldehyde. So toluene gets converted into benzyl chloride first, and by treatment of hydronium ion, it gets converted into benzaldehyde. So this is known as side chain chlorination, which is followed by hydrolysis. And last reaction for preparation of benzaldehyde is Gaterman-Koch reaction, in which benzene is used as reactant with carbon monoxide and hydrochloric acid. And a catalyst used is anhydrous aluminium chloride. Anhydrous means no water content in that, or we can use copper chloride also. So just hydrogen is replaced by CHO from benzene ring, and we'll get benzaldehyde as the product. So benzaldehyde is prepared by these three methods: by oxidation of toluene, by side chain chlorination followed by hydrolysis, and third is by Gaterman-Koch reaction. That's all. Thank you for watching the video.